It all started back in 264 BC, when we, the Carthaginians, occupied the city-state Massana, located on the island of Sicily. Now, of course, there had already been a little tension, like when Rome got angry at us for starting a religious ritual of strangling babies.
My baby!
But there had never been anything close to war. And then Rome just had to attack our city in Sicily, just because their allies, the Mamertines, were being tattletales and complaining about us. All we were doing is killing them and their children and stealing their land. Anyway, Rome hired a leader, Appius Claudius Codex, and the first war began.
Ha! We won battle after battle. We cleaned in the cities of Hieron, Segesto, and Agrigento.
However, battles were getting very costly.
You're dead.
So I realized we had to have a navy, and I built one. Well, I ordered one to be built, but still.
Da-da!
Soon we had a huge navy of 160 ships, all equipped with corvi and land bridges attached to the ship that allowed our troops to board the ships, taking away their advantage of better ships. Using this strategy, we managed to take control of the seas. And using this control, we finally managed to force Carthage, led by Hamilcar Barca, to surrender.
We will never surrender!
Yes, you will.
Fine.
So after 23 years of war, we emerged victorious. We charged in 3,200 gold talents, and in the war destroyed a whopping 500 Carthaginian ships. Ha.
Well, we destroyed 600 of your ships.
So?
And killed 50,000 of your people.
What you trying to say, punk?
Nothing.
That's what I thought. Anyway, we were rightly victorious.
Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Awesome.
Yeah!
After the first war, we were weak but still strong. To make up for the loss of Sicily, my dad, Hamilcar, decided to settle Spain. Real smart, right?
No!
I wasn't talking to you. Anyway, he took me and his forces west to Spain and started new colonies there. Of course, there were some small hamlets already there, but we quickly destroyed each one. Unluckily, one of these towns was a Roman ally. Rome was not happy. And so the Second War began.
Dun dun!
Soon afterwards, my dad died. Of course, being the brave guy I was, I handled it very well.
Oh, why did this have to happen? It's all my fault.
Yes, Simba. Run. Run away and never return.
Oh, wait. Wrong script.
Yes. Soon I will be gone. You must swear an oath against the Romans.
Yes, father.
Bleep!
And so I swore an oath against the Romans and became leader of the Carthaginian army. Some will call me the greatest military mind in history after Alexander the Great. Of course, I think I'm better than him, but nobody cares what Hannibal the Great General has to say. Anyway, I mounted one of the most ambitious expeditions in history. I took my army through the Pyrenees, the Rhone Valley, and the Alps. Oh yeah, and I heard there was another general in town for the Romans, a certain Scipio.
Soon after I became general, news was brought that Hannibal was planning an attack through the Alps. At first I thought he was crazy, then I realized he was insane.
Woo! Climb these mountains, people!
Well, what I saw made me truly know he was a madman. Oh, in both ways. He was leading 90,000 infantry, 12,000 cavalry, some siege weapons, and elephants. 3 dozen elephants.
When I saw the look on Scipio's face, I cracked up. Ha. They walked up to us all confident, and then we creamed them. Then we just wandered across the Alps, beating army after Roman army, and battle after crushing battle. Rome suffered two of the greatest defeats in history. One, the Battle of Lake Trasimene, and the other, the Battle of Cannae. It was epic.
Isn't it epic? A very, very long poem that no one understands or can tolerate unless they have really good foam earplugs, which haven't been invented yet, and I'm not supposed to know what those are. I would be wrong, and you would be wrong.
I deny your rights.
But, sir, that breaks the laws of the Constitution of the United States of America, which won't be around for almost 2,000 years now.
Will somebody please get him out of here? How the heck did he get in here in the first place?
How dare you, heckle? I'm so confused.
Are you confused? Oh, look, it's becoming nighttime, and the grass is green. I love green grass. Great.
Anyway, back to the epic battles. In the Battle of Lake Trasimene, we surprise attacked the Romans and literally forced them into the lake.
Boom! Ah!
That was in 216 BC. The next year, in the Battle of Cannae, the biggest defeat Rome ever suffered, we were seriously outnumbered by the thousands. However, we surrounded them and killed almost 55,000 of them.
Ah! Oh! Ah!
Altogether, both of the battles had pretty much the same outcome. Death for them.
But then things started to go my way, as they always do because I'm so awesome. I took an army to Carthage and defeated the small amount of soldiers there.
Die!
And that, plus the few naval victories we had on the way, cut off the Hannibal's supply lines, and that is when he totally started getting desperate.
I did not totally start getting desperate. All I did was follow the original plan to attack Rome. Right, guys?
What? No, the original plan was to...
Ha! He had tried to attack our city, but he never got through the walls. Then he tried to incite rebellion among the tribes we had conquered. But they were all too scared of me and the punishments I would give, right?
Quod?
What?
Quid dicere?
Huh? Well, I assume that means yes.
Well, I was sort of maybe halfway through breaking the wall when Scipio started attacking northern Africa near Carthage, so I was forced to return home to defend.
There were a few battles beforehand, but we defeated Hannibal in the Battle of Zama. We had won the war again, as I always knew we would.
They forced us to sign a treaty that we would give up our entire navy, all of our land in Spain, and 10,000 gold talents. 10,000!
Yes, we truly won again.
When the Second War ended, Carthage was a mere shadow of its former glory, but we were still decently strong. And of course, most citizens have to agree, I'm almost as good of a political leader as I am of a general. Soon Carthage was back to its former glory. Then, the Numidians, an ally of the Romans, they had kept picking at us. And we couldn't do anything about it, because that would be breaking the treaty. Basically, it was like this, except a lot bigger.
Poke, 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 poke.
Yeah, you get the point. Finally, we were forced into attacking the Numidians, breaking the treaty that Rome decided to make a series of ridiculous demands. Like, literally like this.
Give us all your children.
They demanded that we destroy our city. And when we refused, they started the Third War.
Now, at this time, I decided to adopt a grandson as my successor, Scipio Aemilius.
I decided to take my army to the Carthage and besiege their city. This lasted for 3 years before we finally breached the walls and destroyed the city.
After that, we destroyed all their other Carthaginian settlements. Oh yeah, and we salted their city to keep their crops from growing.
Haha, take that, Carthage!
Dude, it's dirt.
Aw. Haha, take that, Carthage!
Dude, the cap's still on.
Aw.
We had emerged victorious in the third and final war. We had won.